How's everybody doing?
Great.
What we're going to start off with is a demonstration called Balancing Nails. I don't know if any of you guys have heard of it. You might have,
So the materials that you're going to need for this demonstration are a block of wood, as you can see here, a nail that's already nailed right in the center of it. You're going to need 11 more identical nails. So now I'm just going to do what I told you I was going to do, balance nails. Gosh, it's not working. It sucks. Alright, we'll have a solution to that problem. And the trick to doing this is a pattern. And you're gonna see on the screen is you're gonna need to lay one nail flat on the table. And then you're gonna need to start laying nails to the left and to the right in alternating directions. So you have four on one side and five on the other. And you're going to take your last nail, lay it the opposite direction as your first nail, and pick it up carefully. You're going to find the center of gravity and put it on the screen. You can see I bounced all the time. Single nail. Now Chris is going to do a demonstration called this spill knots.
Demonstrate you guys to spill knots. You need a cup, apple full of water, and then a little cup holder like this. It's flexible. What you're going to do is just spin it. The reason it's staying in place is because of the force. As a trick for the force is acting upon it, just making the cup stay in one place. You can look up at it. If you get real skilled, you can do it on one finger. If I ain't no skill yet, but work on it. That's the reason why the force acting upon the cup is pushing it down. And also, as a trick for the force is making it go in a circle, it's keeping it in place. But if you save it, it's not going to fall anymore. Now this demonstration is called the surface tension jar. And the materials that you're going to need for this is a tray that's 7 inches deep. Actually, move this over to here. And you're going to need a laminated card. And two jars with screw-on lids. And one's gonna have a mesh screen in it, still able to let water go through. Alright? So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna take the laminated card, lay it over the top, and you're gonna turn it 180 degrees. And some water will come out, but that's just showing that air pressure is occurring. And what's happening is when I remove my hand, the laminated card is staying stuck to it. I'm sure some of you guys have done it before, but what's happening is water pressure is coming down as air pressure is trying to go up into the cup and there's air. What's also occurring is, and what this is creating is a vacuum. So I'm gonna remove the card and the water's all gonna fall off. Now you're gonna do the same thing with the jar, but this jar has a screen mesh in it. Turn 180 degrees, you see air pressure, and now you're going to remove the card. The water stays in the jar. You go up and down, and no water's coming out. Now, what's happening here is called surface tension. And if I turn it to the left, I turn it to the right, the water falls out. Alright. Now I'm gonna explain to you how this works. Now, with the screen mesh, surface tension is demonstrated because, well, actually, in order to understand how these both work, you're going to need to understand when they wouldn't work. And these wouldn't work if we were using alcohol like we have here, because the bonds, the surface tension bonds, aren't as strong as water. And also, what surface tension does is it's a net attractive force that pulls down on adjacent molecules such as the water. And when you flip it, there's hundreds of water molecules and little bubbles that will actually form on here, holding all of the water inside of the jar. And I explained the vacuum on that.
All right, now I'm demonstrating to you guys.
Never-ending radical dude. So stay like that. All right. apply 5 pumps. As you can see, a cloud is formed inside the bottle. That's why it's called the palpable bottle. Pay attention closely as I apply pressure into the bottle. The cloud is fading away. This time I'm going to add 15 pumps, and what's occurring as I add pressure is the molecules are being squeezed together really tightly. And therefore, they're all compacted. So the second we release, it allows the molecules to expand rapidly and allows them to cool and condense. And that's what happens in our clouds when water vapor is compressed and released. It expands rapidly, and you get a cloud after condensing. That's cloud in a bottle.
First thing you're going to do, try to strike your gap real hard and fast. Good. Make sure your fingers are out the way, because if you smash them, they will go hard. Thank you.
connecting to the base, allowing the pressure to move from left to right. Then you have the mid-arm connecting to the swivel base, then the mid-arm to the fulcrum, and then the fulcrum to the grippers. And they all have axes. So an axis is going from this point to that point.
All right, I'm going to demonstrate you guys the bed of nails. You need two balloons, 100 nails, and an extra nail, a piece of wood like this. It works. Then you try to pop the balloon with one nail. Then you take the other balloon, put it down right here. And you apply pressure.
Alright. Now pay attention closely.
I'm putting a lot of pressure down here. Now you see the balloon is forming. The reason this works is because the mass of the balloon is spread out over all the nails. Have you ever seen like a crazy video of some guy laying on a bed of nails? It works because all his weight is spread out all evenly. Then his weight was just put at one point, he probably started getting a lot of scratches. And yeah, probably dies. You see? Hold it down pretty hard, and still not popping. See? That's the better nails.
Alright, real quick, I'll explain to you how this works. And the way that this works is by using the single nail, all of the pressure is being applied. I guess the air's coming out. All the pressure is being applied at this tip. But when I laid the balloon onto the bed of nails, all of its surface area was spread, it spread it out. So basically all of the pressure was divided and it wasn't giving 100% pressure onto one point, allowing the balloon to pop. All right, now we're moving over there.
And sodium tablets. First thing to do, just pour the water in up to 100. Then if you do that, you add an indicator solution. It might have a reaction with the water and turn different colors.
It's a weird name, but it's called phenolphthalein, and it's an acid-based substance that's clear in water, but it won't be once you see this reaction.
Then you take your mineral oil for 200. There's an interface between the water and the mineral oil. It's really dense. If you combine the sodium with the water, it makes a very strong base. You have the sodium in the rocks because it oxidizes very quickly. Take the sodium tablet like that, and you drop it straight in, and it goes through the mineral oil, hits the water, and a reaction occurs. It kind of bubbles up like a mini explosion in the water. It goes through the mineral oil to the interface, which is right here, the little lock. This reaction happens, and it creates hydrogen oxide and sodium oxide. You see, it kind of goes to the mineral oil, then back down to the water, shoots back up, and it does it a few times before it runs out of the reaction. So that's the same one with sodium. All right,
now we're gonna do a demonstration called the maglev train, and what this is using is the simple properties of magnets. For example, everyone knows that if you try to put a north face magnet and a north face magnet together, what do they do? Exactly. So this side is facing north, and so is the magnetic strips. So are the magnetic strips inside. So this allows the vehicle to float freely. And we're going to demonstrate it. Moves really slowly.
demonstrate one more time.
Alright, now explain what a maglev is. And what a maglev is short for magnetic levitation. So all that's occurring is because they're retracting each other, there's a magnetic field allowing this to float and they're pulling away. And the two wires that are touching the track are powering the motor and pushing it along the track. That's really simply how the maglev works, and China's actually trying to make maglev vehicles. I think they already have some. India as well. Yeah. That's how it works.
And also, the two wires don't touch, it causes a lot of friction, which makes your maglev vehicle just stay in one place.
That's it.
Now we have to demonstrate to you guys elephant toothpaste. You might have already heard of this. Potassium iodine.
Also known as old foamy.
And sodium iodine. And you see we have food coloring, a beaker, and some soap. You use any kind of food coloring, it works either way.
Alright. So, in here we have yellow food coloring. In here we have green food coloring. Also with hydrogen peroxide and some dishwashing liquid. Now we're gonna pour the sodium and potassium iodide inside and see what reaction we get.
That's how this works.
Thank you for coming.